This video is part one of the Starfish Age Managers training video series. In this first section, we'll explore arriving at the beach and how the Starfish Nipper session starts.
Each club will be different. You may welcome your whole Nipper age group together. So in the past, Anglesey has welcomed their whole Nipper age group here on the lawn. And we would make sure that our Starfish were on this side of the area, so they can have the option of spreading out over here onto the ramp. You can see Indigo has got her headphones on over there and she's choosing the furthest point from the group to stand. If a participant has sensory sensitivities, they may wish to wear their headphones, and that's absolutely fine. So loud announcements can trigger people with those sensory sensitivities. So this would be a really good setup for our Starfish. And then they're the first ones to lead off, and we'll leave a bit of space between the Starfish group and the others. It's important that they're part of taking the equipment down. So your age group Starfish nippers will bring down their nipper boards. Our Starfish will bring down their nipper boards, their Starfish boards, the music equipment, our Starfish flags, just as the other age group nippers do too. And when you arrive down at the beach, the welcome routine, you can create your own welcome routine, and this is just a suggestion. Indigo has volunteered to be our Starfish nipper for the purpose of this video today. At the start of your session, once they have set their equipment down on the beach, the Starfish nipper with their trainer next to them will come and join the Starfish circle that we've got set out here. The parents and carers huddle around that circle, but just in the circle is the Starfish with their trainer next to them. And we start off with a Starfish chant, or the Go Starfish chant, which sets the session up. And ours has evolved. Initially, our purpose was just to do our hands in the middle and do Go Starfish, but one of our Starfish nippers loved everything in three. So now we do that as for a pattern of three. All right, you ready, Indy? So we do one, two, three, Go Starfish. Ready? One, two, three, Go Starfish. And we do it again. One, two, three, Go Starfish. One more time. One, two, three, Go Starfish. And then we move into the Starfish song. So there's words you can print out. And we actually have a kit of musical instruments. Often people with a disability love music, and they can have a free choice from the music tub and play the music if they don't want to join in with the singing, or they can sing and play at the same time. Trainers and helpers, we encourage them to join in with this. And we have words for the families standing around as well. Next is the roll marking. We encourage our Starfish, even if they are very shy, just to say yes or to give a gesture that they are here. And if they're not able to do this, then the trainer will respond with them or on their behalf. Then announcements. If anyone from the group has any announcements about something that they have done or something that's coming up that they want the Starfish family to be aware of, that's a really great time to share that information. Then we move into a stretch circle, so staying in the circle setup, and we go through some stretching routines. And sometimes you might need to help your Starfish. You might come along and be helping them with their stretch position, but otherwise the trainer and Starfish are just working together at whatever level is accessible for their Starfish. We actually add in a strength section as well, so it can be some body weight exercises. And so the strength part is really important for the Starfish, and they end up getting great gains across the Starfish program. And again, it's just working at the individual's levels. Then we move into a fun game to start the session, and on the Starfish members section, you'll see this under the activity outlines. There's a whole list of fun activities you can do as either welcome activities or closing activities.
Session overview suggestions are provided in the member section on the Starfish Australia website. However, we understand that all programs will run for differing time periods, and these are suggestions only.
An example of a session timetable, and we've got some visuals within there as well. So at the start, you'll see this part here, which is our arrival or welcome, which is the routine that we've just worked through. Then some examples of warm-up activities. Beach activities next, water activities, and then the closing and pack up routine. So this is a 5-session overview of what you can do within your program. And detailed, further detail to that, some of your participants may need visual cues, and that becomes a story for them of what's going to be happening throughout the day. So these are some, so if, the first on your visual cue board, you might have your warm-up activity, and you would point to that, or the starfish song. Actually, all of these relate to the start session. So you have your go starfish, starfish song, warm-up, and then you'd move into your beach icons. So you might be doing flags on that day, so the flags visual cue would appear on your board. And what some of our participants like to do is to actually peel these off. So once they have finished doing an activity, they would peel that off the board and put it down the bottom, so they know that that activity has been done and that they are moving through the starfish session activity by activity. Through your session overview, it's good to do a thumbs up check for understanding, to make sure that all of the starfish are aware of what's coming up and happening for the day. So you can do that as you point to each of the visual cues on the visual cue board to support our diverse range of participants within the program. Also, just a reminder that when we go into the water activities, you must have a one-to-one ratio with your water safety. So one qualified water safety person, SRC is fine, or bronze, but it must be current, to one starfish nipper. And that's irrespective of how long the starfish has been in the program, how capable they are. It is just a blanket ruling that it must be that one qualified person to the starfish participant. Start of the session, it's a great idea to do a water safety awareness and beach safety check. For example, today at Anglesey, it's very windy. That is going to be a trigger for many of your participants, particularly those on the autism spectrum. It will set them off a little, so maybe think about an area where you may have a quiet space where they can sit. If you can find an area that's out of the wind, or have a mini tent set up for a day such as this. But also, if we have a look over here, we've got the seaweed all over the beach today. And if it's been there for a little while, then the seaweed will be quite hard, and that will be painful on their feet. But also, just from a textural point of view, for those with sensory sensitivities, that's a beach safety consideration. Water safety today, the waves are dumping. So we may sit as a starfish group and have a look and say, what do we notice about the beach today? And have a beach check-in at the start of each session. We have starfish flags that clubs can choose to purchase, and that starfish flag moves with us throughout the session. So as we go from activity to activity, we have the flag with us, so that if a parent needs to take their starfish to the toilet, they can come back and find where we are on the beach. Also, trainers could be aware of where they should be at all times with their starfish too. So our starfish flag would come back to our place where we started our session at the end, and everyone would join in the circle, same as we did at the start. And this time we put our hands in the middle and we say, 1, 2, 3, goodbye starfish. And you can do that 3 times as well, the same as you did at the start. And then that will conclude the session. And also a nice thing to do is to go around the circle and say to the starfish, what was your favourite thing that you did today? And again, if the starfish can build their confidence to respond themselves, that's fantastic. If they can't, the trainer might say, I noticed that I saw Olivia really enjoying the board activity today. Boards is often a favourite. We do have the starfish boards, which are available directly from G Boards in Torquay. And they will allow you to have they're a larger board and a thicker board, so that you can have your starfish on the front and the trainer on the back. And we find that gives the participants a lot of joy, being able to feel safe and supported on the boards in the water.
We hope that you found part one of the Starfish Age Managers training video series useful, and now we'll encourage you to view and engage with part two, where you'll explore differentiation and examine a range of scenarios.